I grew up in the Appalachian Mountains, up there in the Appalachian Mountains of Virginia. Now, I didn't know it when I was growing up and didn't find out until recently that those Appalachian Mountains were actually named for a tribe, a bunch of people from down here in Florida. Those first tourists that we had up there in the Appalachian Mountains. Appalachian Indians, the Appalachian people who were doing their best to avoid being slaughtered by DeSoto and his bunch, ran into those mountains, and those mountains have been called Appalachians ever since. Some people call them the Appalachian Mountains, the Appalachians. I call them Appalachians because I grew up near Appalachian. But up in the southwestern corner of Virginia, Appalachian Mountains are the oldest standing mountains in the world. 850 million years old they are. And 850 million years ago, when they rose up out of that great bubbling cauldron of creation, they reached the sky and they spanned the continent. Because that was only one continent at that time. What was it? Pangaea. And the Appalachian Mountains are like the backbone of Pangaea. About 250 million years ago, give or take a day or two, Carrie. I know you're a stickler for details, so give or take a couple of days. 250 million years ago, that continent broke up and started drifting apart. And those Appalachian Mountains drifted apart as well. Some of them ended up way over in China, some of them over in Poland. Some of them, they're just around, they're still there, the second oldest standing mountains. But in the Appalachian Mountains of Virginia, where I grew up, there's a great wealth of natural resources, the coal, the timber, all the things that people have kind of taken out of there and put somewhere else. I went to the Czech Republic a few years ago, went to a beautiful castle over there, a little south of Brno. And this beautiful castle had this incredible black walnut staircase built out of Appalachian walnut. And I thought, ain't that a wonder, you know, that we have come this far. Because I didn't grow up in a palace. I grew up in the mountains. I grew up on a little farm down there on the Clinch River. My people had come into Virginia there through the Moccasin Gap. Right there, just across the Tennessee, what's now the Tennessee line. You know where it is. You live in Abingdon, so you know where it is. The Moccasin Gap was a place where it was sort of a natural funnel of people that came into that mountains because they were following, of course, the game trails and the streams and the rivers. And Daniel Boone came through there a couple of years before. Saw a bunch of Indian moccasin tracks, which was really not a surprise when you think about it. Because the Indians knew better than to climb the mountain. They just went through the gaps, too. They call it gap, a moccasin gap. And my people, the Bledsoes anyway, were long hunters. They were out there just kind of looking for whatever was out there. I guess probably mostly getting out there hunting and trying to find some land. And they found some land there in Scott County, Virginia. And when they settled in there, they didn't have much. A few tools, maybe. Animals, maybe. What they did was they scratched out a living out of those mountains. But what they brought in there with them, that was the most important thing, was their songs and their stories and their culture and their way of living. Ways of living that has sort of sustained people for a couple of hundred years, over 250 years now. And I'm going to share a little bit of that with you tonight. If I can just shut up talking. Here's an old song y'all might know and help me sing. Now, Polly, pretty Polly, come go along with me. Polly, pretty Polly, come go along with me. Before we get married, some pleasures to see. Down with the old Willie, I'm afraid of your way. Willie, oh Willie, I'm afraid of your way. The way you've been rambling, you'll lead me. Polly, you're guessing about right. Polly, pretty Polly, you're guessing about right. I dug on your grave the best part of last night. He led her over hills and dark valleys so deep. He led her over hills and dark valleys so deep. Now Polly mistrusted and she began to weep. Oh, Willie, oh, Willie, now please don't take my life. Willie, oh, Willie, please don't take my life. Let me go, single girl, for I won't be your wife. Now Polly, pretty Polly, that never can be. Means trouble to me. But he stabbed her in her bosom and her heart's blood did flow. He stabbed her in her bosom, her heart's blood did flow. And into that grave pretty Polly did go. And he threw little dirt over her and turned to go home. He threw little dirt over her and turned to go home. Even none but the wild birds behind him to moan. It's a debt to the devil that Willie must pay. A debt to the devil that Willie.